Before proceeding, please make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. This video is a quick review on fertilization, the formation of the three germ layers and their folding, and the process of neurulation or the neural tube formation. Fertilization is a process of fusion between male sperm and female oocyte. This process takes place in the fallopian tube of a female reproductive system. Each month, an egg or oocyte is released from the ovary of the female reproductive system. This oocyte is taken up immediately into the fallopian tubes. At this point, the oocyte is lined up by a layer of glycoprotein called the zona pellucida. Over this layer of zona pellucida, clusters of cells will be arranged in a radiated pattern called the corona radiata. In the presence of millions of sperms present in the fallopian tube, only one of them, probably the most active one, will interact with the oocyte, and eventually their nuclei will fuse with each other, making up a zygote. The zygote is now a fertilized egg. This fertilized egg, or zygote, will undergo a series of cell divisional stages, and will convert into a 2-cell, then 4, and then 8-cell mass. These cell divisional stages are called the cleavage stages. As the 8-cell mass grows further through cell division, it converts into a morulla. The morulla is a 16-cell mass. The morulla will undergo cell division and will convert into a 32-cell mass called the blastula. The blastula will contain two groups of cells. The group of cells lining the periphery of the blastula is called the outer cell mass, and the group of cells present at the center of the blastula is called the inner cell mass. The future baby will develop from this inner cell mass, and the outer cell mass will form the supporting tissues of the baby, like the placenta. As the blastula grows further, the layer of zona pellucida dissolves away, and water starts accumulating within the blastula. The blastula now becomes the blastocyst. The cells of the outer cell mass lining the blastocyst is called the trophoblast. The inner cell mass will compact at a certain place and are now called the embryoblast. The trophoblast will later on convert into two layers of cells. But we will not get into detail of this. As it's a quick review, the focus of this video will be the embryoblast only. This blastocyst will implant at the uterine wall by the end of the first week after fertilization. This implanted blastocyst is now called the embryo. If a cross-section of this embryo is taken at the second week of implantation, the embryoblast has developed into two layers of cells. The upper epiblastic layer, shown in red, and the lower hypoblastic layer, shown in green. The epiblastic layer will outline the amniotic cavity, and the hypoblastic layer will surround the yolk sac. Together, the epiblastic and the hypoblastic layer makes up the bilaminar disc. If we make a cut at the amniotic and the yolk sac and focus on this bilaminar disc only, upon a lateral superior view, it will look something like this. At this point, some cells of the epiblast will degenerate in a longitudinal fashion. This degenerated area is now called the primitive streak and the primitive node. At the head or the cranial end of this bilaminar disc, the epiblastic and the hypoblastic layers are held tightly at a specific area by the underlying cells of the hypoblast. This specific area is called the precaudal plate, and this precaudal plate will become the future mouth of the baby. At the rostral or the tail end, this bilaminar disc is limited by the cloacal membrane. The cloacal membrane will become the future anus of the baby. If this bilaminar disc is flipped 90 degrees towards the left, upon a superior view, we will have this looking structure. At this point, some cells from the primitive node will grow towards the precaudal plate. It will form a tube-like structure called the notochord. The notochord lies in between the epiblast and the hypoblast, and this notochord will eventually become the nucleus pulposus of the intervertebral disc. As the third week arises, the cells of the epiblast will proliferate and invaginate the primitive node and the primitive streak, and will give rise to a third layer of cells, which on a cross-section will look something like this. The bilaminar disc, which had two layers before, is now converted into three layers of cells. A superficial layer of ectoderm, and immediately under this ectodermal layer lies the notochordal tube. The endodermal layer lying beneath the notochord, and the newly formed mesoderm, which was derived from the epiblast, lies lateral to the notochord. All these three germ layers makes up the trilaminar disc, and the process by which these three germ layers are formed is called gastrulation. Each one of these three germ layers will give rise to different structures of the human body. Neurulation is a process of the neural tube formation, and it originates from the ectodermal germ layer of the embryo. The neural tube will give rise to the central nervous system and the spinal cord. Under the influence of the underlying notochord, the superficial ectoderm will proliferate and thickens at a certain area just above the notochord. This area of the ectoderm depresses downwards with its sides raising upwards. The depressed area of this ectoderm is now called the neural groove, and its raised sides are called the neural folds. And this was a cross-sectional view which we talked about. While the neural groove will keep depressing downwards, the neural folds will keep raising upwards. The cells present at the edges of these neural folds becomes the neural crest, which will later on detach as the neural folds meet each other and the neural tube is formed. At the end of this neurulation process, which started at the third week, the ectoderm will be seen covering the neural tube, the neural crest cells, the much enlarged mesoderm, and the underlying endoderm. This makes sense in a way that the ectoderm will become the future skin of the baby. The folding of embryo will take place in two planes, along the rostrocranial and the lateral axis. In the next video, we will talk about the pharyngeal arches, their derivatives, and the embryology of the jaws. Please make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon to get notified on upcoming videos. Thank you for watching.